Nature always fascinates me because it is lively and keeps throwing at us new colors. So, we need to be humble and do express our gratitude for the simple things that nature offered us in our lives. I always admire the raindrops when they hit the earth. They double the beauty of grass and leaves. The earthly smell that comes from the wet ground has mesmerizing effect. Wow! Staring at the acidic sky, feeling the silver liquid drops kissing my palms makes me feel heavenly. In some way, it soothes my restless mind and streamlines my thoughts. With this prudent saying, I will start my today's vlog. It will take you through a day in my life that turned out a tedious one, but I think it will help you stay connected, as I am going to take you through the few crucial stuffs that must be taken care of before starting a trip. I mean, a long vacation. Though I hesitate laundering on a daily basis, but it's always first on my to-do list when it comes to traveling. I don't wish to return back to a huge pile of dirty clothes that will just add up to the trip return dirty clothes. So I always make sure I finish any remaining laundry and put it away a day before. Coming home to a clean house with no immediate chores to catch up with will continue your feeling of post-vacation bliss. Since both my parents and in-laws are in Odisha, we decided to spend our last 3 months of this year with them. Staying away and stressing out was no more a solution. We needed to be together. In fact, most of us are longing for the same. Besides packing and organizing the suitcases, there are many other things that come into the eyes which needs to be attended. Whether you will be out of town for a few days or a few weeks, if you prepare your home in advance, you will enjoy a smooth return. I know it's really hard job to get motivated to clean before you are going, but you will love coming back from holidays tired and walking through the door knowing that the house is clean. Second comes freeze cleaning. I'm sure most of you do clean the fridge without fail, as no one would wish to return home to a fridge full of rotten and stinky stuffs. Am I right? I sort the veggies and check if I could use it for the day or I shall donate it to the needy. The leftovers also needs to be checked whether to use or discard. And once sorted, I give a dry wipe to remove all the dry food particles. Followed by a wet wipe to remove any spills. I don't do a deep cleaning though, and once done, I stock my dry packed foods. Next comes washing dishes. In this situation, it has taken a toll on all of us. It's an extra work added on our to-do list. Sometimes it's stressful, but there is no escape. Anyways, there is one positive side of it. I don't have to be dependent on the maid to finish my pending works. Emptying the trash cans is a very important task, and so without fail, it's in my next to-do list. I'm sure you probably take out the trash regularly as it's a part of daily cleaning routine, but do you take a good look at the inside? Just because you can't see or smell the germs doesn't mean that they are not there. As a general rule, it's a good idea to give your trash cans a good deep clean at least once a month, or more frequently in the event of a leakage. I make sure to deep clean all my bins just to avoid the foul smell and germs at least twice a week. I make sure I clean the unreachable areas with the help of used brush. It's like a savior tool. Once I finish the major cleaning job, I make sure to clean the jalis, as a lot of sediments are found attached on it. So my advice would be to clean it thoroughly and give a good scrub to the basins. I had read it somewhere, cleaning your home before vacation isn't just for your own sanity. It's also preventing things from going awry. And for me, it's peace of mind. Crucial things that needs to be handled. If you are out for a short vacation, water your plants generously just before you leave to make sure the soil stays hydrated. You can also create your own self-watering system. Thanks to my neighbors, they are there for the rescue. I asked them to take care of my plants, hence I left them on the corridors. Generally, my maid used to serve this job when I was out. But now the situation is different. and I have no house help. Unplugging all the small appliances including water purifier, chimney plug, followed by a wipe and putting them inside the cabinets make me feel relaxed mentally, as this makes me sure that nothing unnecessary items are plugged in. And the last one, right before you leave, it's wise to check all the possible entry points around your home. Make sure you haven't left any seldom used doors or windows unlocked or cracked open. It's easy to forget about that side door that rarely gets used. If you are still watching the vlog till this end, I hope you found it useful. If you did like my content, then please do like, share and subscribe my channel. Stay tuned to travel with me my hometown in my next vlog. Meet you soon. Till then, stay safe and sound.